Hey, total y'all family at this time. May the peace of y'all come upon you when you learn to obey him, brothers and sisters. I had to do a very important video at this time. We're going to be dealing with the lesson called Esau. That is very important to show you the location of Esau and the future location of Esau, brothers and sisters, that you may know where his seed dwell at today, because there's a lot of controversy going on among our people. And a lot of falsehood is being spread and referring to Esau as European people, the white man, they called him in the modern term. Brother, you can see that further from the truth, brothers and sisters. You can see the seed of Esau in the location. Even I'm going to use this this book right here, the sister book called True Identity, A Spiritual Poetry and Hervitness, to show you some maps there. But first, I'm going to go to the book called Obadiah. They call it. Translated, said Obadiah. And we can start off with verse 1, because it shows you something that is very important. It was a vision. It says, in a vision, Yah, they got the Lord God, but that's false, show Obadiah the future of the land of Edom. They got an A for a referendum to go to the footnote. So we're looking at the land of Edom. It's very important. In the footnote, this is what it states. It's a nation southeast of Yashael, Yah, they got Israel, including Petra, the city hewn from rocks. Her southern boundaries was on the Gulf of Aqaba. So we're going to get into that. The Edom was noted for her wise men, Eliphaz, the wisest of Yaakov's three friends was from Teman, 5 miles east of Petra in Edom. So we talking about southeast, this nation called Edom, Esau, right off from the Gulf of Aqaba. So we're gonna get in there because it's very important. First, I want to read this part of information right here coming from Obadiah. Verse 17. Let me go up a little further to 15. It said, Yah, revenge will soon fall upon the Gentile nations, all the Gentile nations. As you have done to Yashael, Yah, so will it be done to you. For your axe will boomerang upon your heads, and you will drink my cup of punishment upon my Kodesh mountain, and the nation round about will drink it too. Yes, drink and stagger back and disappear from history. No longer nations anymore. Showing that terrible destruction is going to come on this earth. And many nations are going to be wiped out. But Yah Shalom will become a refuge, a way of escape. Yashayel Yah will reoccupy the land. See, Yashayel Yah will be a fire that sets the dry fields of Edom aflame. See, talking about the people. It's not referred to the land. It's talking about the people. There will be no survivors, for Yah has spoken. You see that? I would love to get into the more explanation than that, but I don't want to explain more on that right now. So then my people who live in the Negev, talking about the south, shall occupy the hill country of Edom. Surely the territory of Edom, Esau, is in the south, not the north. Southeast, so keep that in mind. Those living in Yarden lowlands should possess the Philistine plains and repossess the fields of Ephraim and Samaria. And the people of Benjamin should possess Gilead. It's saying Yashayel, Yah exile shall return. See, they got Israelis, but that's false. See, our people shall return and occupy the Phoenician coastal strip as far as north as Sarephath, and those exiled in Asia Minor shall return to the homeland and reconquer the south outlying villages. See, say, for deliverers will come to Yah Shalom and rule all Edom, and Yah shall be king. You see that? So that's the so that he living in all the fuss. Yah gonna be king. So we're gonna go ahead and verify some things from this particular book called True Identity, A Spiritual Poetry Inheritance. So we're going to go here And we're going to look at, give me a moment, I lost my page. I know it's one right here, and we're going to start at 124. Look at this map. The world as known to the Hebrews, according to Mosaic account. So right here, see how we got, they got Japhet, Yafet. See, down in Yafet, see, is the European people. See, right here, we have Canaan land. This is where our territory right here was up to here, to the Euphrates rivers, brothers and sisters, here, and down to here, the Marine River. So we want to go right here. So it's very important. See, right, they got the word Canaan right here, the land that was given to our ancestors right there. You got right here showing that Ishmael dwelt over there. And so down in this territory right here, let me go, I'm going to bring it up right here. This is southeast that you're going to see right here is Edom. So we're going to get another map to bring that up closer. See right here, I want to show you the particular river right here. That river was called right here the Gulf of Aqaba. See, that's the Gulf of Aqaba, the Sea of Reeds right here. See right there, they even show you right there, Edom. See, this territory belonged to Edom. All along up in there was Edom. Remember, they were trying to go in. When they went down here from out of Goshen, from out of Mizraim, they went down here. Met up with Yah around that territory, and then they went back up here to go towards the Canaan land. But Esau seed blocked them dead. So keep that in mind. That's the southeast of Canaan. So keep that in mind as we're going to go ahead. I don't want to make this video too long. I want to show this to you for verification. Right here on page 23. We have the kingdom of Yashar-Yel-Yah. They got Israel and Judah, but Yashar-Yel-Yah and Yah the map. See right here, I'm going to bring it up right here if I can. I'm losing my focus. Right here, see, it said the kingdom of Yashar-Yel-Yah and the kingdom of Yada. See, the southern and the northern. See, remember, that should keep in mind. Yada is the southern nation. Esau dwelled directly southeast of Yada. So keep that in mind. Not all the way up here, right here where Esau dwell. Excuse me, where the Europeans, the Caucasian dwell of Yafet, see all along the coastal lines there. And we got some Shemitic more people over there. And in the deep north, we got more European people up there. See, Yafet seed there. We got some Shem seed there. And over top over here, we had some Hamitic seed. So keep that in mind as well. So right here, we're going to look at this map. See right here? We got the Mediterranean Sea there. The Phoenicians up there. We got the king of Arabic Damascus over there. Syria Empire was there. We got the kingdom of Ammon there, the kingdom of Moab there. See right there, the Ammon was directly across from the kingdom of Yashar-Yel-Yah, overran by Ephraim, the tribe of Ephraim. Right here, Yada, the kingdom of Yada right here, was run by the tribe of Yada. So right here, we got the kingdom of Moab, and then here, see right there? The kingdom of Esau. See where they got the Arabian tribes right there. Arabian tribes. And we got all these different tribes right here. But underneath the kingdom of Moab, here they're just showing you below the picture where you can't even see the sea. Right here of the Gulf of Aqaba, the Reed Sea. That you get into the borders of Esau, even though Esau controlled it. Nobody lived in that wilderness portion, but it still was under the Esau still claimed that particular location. So keep that in mind. So right here, we got the kingdom of Esau right there dwell beneath the kingdom of Yah. Right here, they show you right here. They don't show you right here too much of Esau. But right they got the, they got Am. This is the biblical Yahshua Yel Yah right here. They got the territory right there. We got Am there again. We got Moab there. And then they show right there the arrow down there. It's where Esau dwell. Now up in the north. Where the four beasts came, brothers and sisters. The Greeks came in and conquered our nation. Last nation, the Greco-Roman Empire of Yafet Sea came in and crushed our people. When y'all allowed the use to expel us from the land. So you got to keep that in mind. It wasn't Esau. See, this is how it was. See, right here. Let me go back here. Right here. See, the last city, the Syrians, right there, empire. Abiyah used to expel the northern kingdom out of the land. And then the last kingdom was in the land was the kingdom of Yada. He had the northern nations to drop down from there to come in, that strange nation there, and got rid of them. Somehow people tried to scatter down through this way. But Esau blocked them. See that? See that territory they try to block? They blocked them. And the northern was pushing in. They had a siege there. The ones that tried to escape. So they said some fled out that way down here. They're there. And went down through the, around the kingdom of Esau. Down into the land they call Africa. Africa today. See, they got blocked from Edom. Remember, that's why the father said he hate Esau. And they pushed them back dead. They killed some and pushed the rest and hand them over to capture them and hand them back over to Yafet Sea, Caucasians. So keep that in mind. The Greeks, Romans, the Khazars or whoever. But nevertheless, the European people, brothers and sisters, that's still ruling that land today. So you keep that in mind, not Esau. So right here, just to keep this in mind, in verse 1, it says, a vision of Yahshua Obadiah, the future of the land of Edom. See right there? The nation, southeast of Yahshua Yel-Yah. So keep that in mind. That's very important to know that, brothers and sisters, to know the location. Because many call Esau European white, further from the truth, brothers and sisters. See, the scriptures verify these things. Can I show you one more thing before I end this video? I didn't intend to make this video too long, brothers and sisters. But the words of Yah is sure. It's perfect if you obey them. I want to look at something. If I have time, I want to see, can I cover it real quick? But I showed you. It's dead. But you got to obey Yah to notice. I want to see something. Do they have another piece about Esau real quick before I close out the book? Particular, let me see. Give me a moment. I'm trying to locate something about a piece on Esau real quick to show you that is very important. Give me a moment. I'm trying to locate it. Okay, that's not really talking about Esau right there. Yes, it is. Let me go right here. In verse 1 of Malachi, they call it Malachi right here. Say, here's Yah's message to Yahshua Yah, given through the prophet Malachi. Have loved you very deeply, says Yah. But you retort, really, when was this? And Yah replied, I showed my love for you by loving your father, Yaakov, and I didn't need to. I rejected his very own brother, Esau, and destroyed Esau's mountain and inheritance to give it to the jackals of the desert and of his descendants. Shall say, we will rebuild. It say, if his descendants will say, we will rebuild the ruins, then Yah of hosts will say, try if you like, but I will destroy it again, for that country is named the land of wickedness. See, and their people are called those who Barad does not forgive. You see that? That is the one they call. What do you want to call Mecca? In Saudi Arabia, or that land is land, Yah will not forgive, brothers. Why do you think they got some surrender to the one true God, Allah? They got a black stone Mecca did. Think about these things, brothers, and they wicked is hell did. You saw what they did to the slave they took into slavery did. Castrated the males. And they took majority females. And they do a lot of strange. See, this is the one people go under the radar. It's not known openly as the wicked, but in y'all time they knew that. The land of wickedness, and their people are called those whom Barad does not forgive. See? Oh, Yashayah, lift up your eyes to see what Barad is doing all around the world. Then you will say, truly, Yah, great power goes far beyond the borders. A son honor his father, a servant honor his master. See, I don't want to get into it. So, but it's red did, brothers and sisters. What Esau partially, I read to you what Esau have done. Y'all don't want them, you know, because what Esau done. That's one of the main ones I wanted to show you. But that's part of it, putting the puzzle together concerning Esau. Because of what Esau have done, brothers and sisters, to his own brothers. I'm trying to extend this a little long and see can I fill up that piece real quick to show you. It's not come to me at the moment exactly with this particular scripture, so I'm scanning a little bit as I'm talking to you to get you to meditate and think. Brothers and sisters, concerning the words of Yah. Because this is so important, brothers and sisters, that you learn the ways of Yah. Learn to obey Yah. To submit to his will, brothers and sisters. And not on your own way of thinking like so many of you are doing. I don't want to make this video to get on my brothers and sisters, but let this be a lesson of correction to you. To get in line with Yah and to move away from your own thinking and what you've been taught was false. That Esau is, brothers and sisters, the European man, further from the truth, brothers and sisters. Esau ate into. I'm trying to get it, brothers and sisters. Ate into and help. The European man conquer y'all people, brothers and sisters. Even though it was appointed for our people to be punished and go into exile, brothers and sisters, far away from their borders and sisters. All y'all knew the people would do this in extreme hatred they have towards y'all people. These are things, brothers, you should learn and should know. But the key is to know who is Esau and the location. I gave it unto you in this video. Study these things out, brother. It's simple. Stop trying to find something not there. But trust Yah. The scriptures show you the location of Esau. It show you the location of this enemy of Yah. It give it to you plain. I'm trying to see something here. It give it to you, brothers and sisters, before I end this video. If I can find it, I'm going to end it off quickly as possible with that. If not, brothers and sisters, give me a few more minutes. Meditation and thinking, brothers and sisters, where is the location of Esau? It's dead. Trust the scriptures, brothers and sisters. It's dead. You got to know these things. You got to know the European man, the one you call the white man location, and Esau, Yaakov brother location. You got to know the European man never conquered three territories. He never conquered the land of Ammon. He never conquered the land of Moab, and he never conquered, brothers and sisters, keep in mind, the land of the Moabites. These are the things you must know. For she, I'm looking at judgment on nations. It got something about Esau. Let me cover the thing about Esau real quick. This might be it. It's in chapter 1 of Amos. It's in verse 6. It say, and y'all say Gaza has sinned again and again, and I will not forget it. I will not leave her unpunished anymore. For she sent my people into exile, selling them as slaves in Edom, see, in Esau, see. So he's talking about the people of Gaza. Sold your people to Esau, Edom, see, selling them as slaves in Edom. Or in Edom, they ain't necessarily got to be to, but in Edom. So I will set fire on the walls of Gaza. See, that's their punishment. And all her forts shall be destroyed. And I will kill the people of Ashdod and destroy Ekron and the king of Ashkelon, and all the Philistines left with perish. And Yah has spoken. You get that, brothers and sisters? It said, Yah say, the people of Tyre have sinned again and again, and I will not forget. I will leave them unpunished. I will leave them unpunished anymore. I will not leave them unpunished anymore, for they broke their treaty with their brother. Y'all should yell, Yah. You see that? They attacked and conquered him. You see that? And led him into slavery in Edom. See, talking about Esau. So I will set fire on the walls of Tyre, and it will be burned down, and all its forts and palaces. And y'all say Edom has sinned again and again, and I will not forget it. I will not leave him unpunished anymore. See, talking about the seed of Esau. For he chased his brother, Yashayelah, with the sword. He pitiless and relent anger, see. So I will set fire to Teman, see. And it will burn down all the force of Bozrah. See, they got Bozrah. So we're going to look at this Bozrah right here. They got a B. It's very important. It said Teman was the north of Eden. See, so we're talking about Teman was on the north side of Eden and Bozrah in the south. The entire country will be devastated. See right there. So keep that in mind. How far I'm going around with this? Let's see right here. So that's the punishment for Esau right there. It just gave you a little bit more information about Esau, but that wasn't the piece I was really looking for. But in the book of Mojah, it showed you some punishment coming on Esau there, brothers and sisters. Because what Esau did, see, chased them with the sword. So you can go over these books and read up all the information concerning Esau. It will show you and give you more reference about Esau and how Esau came against his own brother. See, you see that, brothers and sisters? That's Esau. Esau is not the European man. European people might be our distant cousins, but Esau is more near. And we was more vulnerable, and at our weakest point, Esau came into an attack. Our people, you see that with the sword, brothers and sisters, kill some and return some. I wanted to show you that piece, but I can't find it. It's not coming to my mind at the moment. About how it describes what Esau have done. If I get that, and I'm going to give it a couple of more minutes. If I can't get it, then you're going to have to research that for yourself, brothers and sisters. About that piece, how Esau came in. It's not coming to my mind at the moment, how Esau came in at the borders on our people and attacked them, brothers and sisters. I might go to Malachi again to see if it's there. But if not, I'm about to close out because I don't want to extend this video too long. But that's a very important piece to have, to know. Our brothers and sisters. So study these things out. Draw closer to the Father, brothers and sisters. Obey Him. That y'all may cleanse you from all your sins, brothers and sisters. Because He loves you. And He destroyed nations for you. And He's going to destroy nations for you. And give you the best part of the land on the earth, brothers and sisters. Y'all is worthy to be praised and thanks. I'm just scanning it through real quick before I shut it down. Because that would be a wonderful piece to end it off on. But it's just not given to me at this time, coming to me. So I'm just scanning it real quick. I'm trying to scan through some pages. And hopefully Father Thou will fall to me. Esau. I'm looking. I'm going to extend this, brothers, a little bit. I'm going to go to something. I'm going to speed this up real quick. I'm going to go to, real quick, the bell with me. I'm going to go to here. I'm going to go to here. To the stronger quarters and look at the word Esau right here. So this is how you do it if you're trying to locate something with some speed. You pull up and look up the certain word you're looking for, and it gives you all the scriptures, just about all the scriptures that's found under the name Esau. So it's very important. So you stand here with me at this time. So right here, so we're gonna get there. We're looking at we got Esau right here. We got Esau right there. So give me a moment. I'm gonna look at something. Sometimes I have a mark, sometimes I don't. So I'm gonna scan through this real quick and try to find and speed up and cut my chase. Okay, that's not it. I will bring the calamity of Esau upon him. So let me go to Yeremiah 49:8 and see if that's it. I'm going to Yeremiah 49:8. I hope that's it. Then I can close the book. 49:8. At this time, brothers and sisters. That is 49:8 is right here. Flee to the remotest part of the desert, O people of Dedan. See right here? So we got Eden. Right here, referring to Esau's seed right here, the Edomites. Let us focus in on me right here. Try to get some focus here going. I say, and Yah of hosts say, where are all your wise men of the days gone by? Is there not one left in all Teman? Flee to the remotest part of the desert, O people of Dedan. For when I punish Edom. See right, they got Dedan right here. He said, Dedan was the northern of Arabia, see, and was flourishing caravan city of the time of Jeremiah and Ezekiel, see right there. See, Dedan, Esau dwelled northern of Arabia, where it will be called Saudi Arabia, see, Saudi Arabia, Esau Arabia, so keep that in mind, brothers and sisters. The people in that, and remember, Esau had a huge family, tribes. Esau dwelled in the land they call Esau today, Saudi Arabia. See right there? It's in the book. I didn't write this book. Brothers are arguing with me, but it's dead. They know this. See, the dad was in northern Arabia. So keep that in mind. So right here, south, which is southeast of the kingdom of Yada. So keep that in mind as well. So let me get back to my place real quick. It's I read that Dedan, for when I punish Edom, I will punish you. Those who gather grapes. So they did leave a few for the poor, even if these don't take everything. But I will strip bare the land of Esau, see? And there will be no place to hide her children, her brethren, her neighbors, and all who will be destroyed. And she herself will purge too. But I will preserve your fatherless children who remain, and let your widows depend upon me. Yah said to Edom, if the innocent must suffer, how much more must you? You should not go unpunished. You must drink this cup of judgment. For I have sworn by my own name, says Yah, that Bozrah shall become a heap of ruins, curse and mock, and her cities shall be eternally waste. I have heard this message from Yah, see? And he has sent a message to call the nations to form a coalition against Edom and destroy her. And I will make her weak among the nations and despised by all, says Yah. You have been fooled by your fame and your pride, living there in the mountain of Petra and the cliffs of the rocks. But though you live among the peaks with the eagles, I will bring you down, says Yah. See, the eagle is not a symbol. That's what they call the European symbol. But not, it was the same, though they live among the high cliffs like the eagles, see? But that's not their symbol. They, remember, their symbol is the sword. They live by the sword. I will bring you down, says Yah. The fate of Edom will be horrible, and all who go by will be appalled and gasped at the sight. Your city will become a silence as Sodom and Gomorrah and their neighbors ring towns, says Yah. No one will live there anymore. I will send against them one who will come like a lion from the wilds of Yarden, see, stalking the sheep and the foes. Suddenly Edom shall be destroyed, and I will appoint over Edomites the person of my choice. See that? For who is like me who can call me to account? What shepherd can defy me? Take note. Yah will certainly do this to Edom and the people of Teman. Even the little children will be dragged away as slaves, and it will be a shocking thing to see. The earth shall shake with the noise of Edom fall. The crowd of people is heard as far as the Red Sea. See? The Red Sea is the Gulf of Aqaba. See, and the one who will come will fly as swift as a vulture and will spread his wings against Bozrah. Then the courage of the mightiest warrior will disappear like that of a woman in labor. That is the judgment on Esau. I still ain't get to what I want to show you, but that's what you got to study more on this, brothers and sisters. Because it's very important that you get this. Because Yah said this is the judgment on Esau. And all these judgments concerning Esau have not come to pass yet. So these things you got to keep in mind, brothers and sisters, as you study the words of Yah and learn to obey the words of Yah. I show you on the location of Esau over and over again in this video, brothers and sisters. The territory got nothing to do with up there in the north. Above the northern tribe of our nation, territory in the north where Yafetzi dwell, the Caucasian brothers and sisters that came in our land last. Who Esau helped, brothers and sisters? Please do your homework. It's there. With that, I don't have nothing else to say to that, y'all.